Welcome to RPF. In this video, we'll discuss about if-else loop used in Microsoft Power Automate. So Microsoft Power Automate is one of the RPA-based tool which is helping enterprises to build an no-code-based automation framework or automation path. So we'll see here how to use if-else or else-if conditions using Microsoft Power Automate. So if you are visiting this channel first time and you want to learn about RPA with different tool set, then please subscribe us. So here I've created one flow. So whenever a user will enter different set of numbers, that will launch a different browser. Let me run this code and then we'll see the result. After that, I will build this code from scratch. So let's see if I'm entering 2 here. So this will launch Google Chrome, where google.com will be open. If I will run it again and enter 3, this time it will launch Microsoft Edge with google.com. So this is how we can set the conditions to launch the browser based on the condition met. If I will enter other than 123, then this will launch Excel file, which is a blank Excel file, which we can see it here. So let's see how we can build the flow from scratch. I'm deleting all the activities and will build in front of you. So first, we will need display input box, the input dialog box. Here, we will set the dialog title. So enter code to launch browser. Now, in the message box, what we want here? So please enter code to launch the browser. Default value, we don't want anything. And whenever we will create this activity, by default, it will create variable. So my variable name is user input. Save this. After that, what we want if conditions. So here we'll use if, and first operand I want as user input. And operator is equal to, we have several other options. We can set any value according to our requirement. Here, I will set this as 1. So whenever user will enter 1, this will launch Internet Explorer. So for launching this, what we want here, launch Internet Explorer. And here we can set the URL as well. So as of now, we want www.google.com. We'll copy this. And save it. Now, based on the input, it will launch Internet Explorer. If user will enter other than 1, so here we'll use else if conditions and we'll use user input equal to 2. This time I want one more else if conditions, and again we'll set here user input as a variable and 3. Save this. After that, I want to launch different browser set. So here, this time you will use Chrome. So whenever user will select 2 or enter value 2, this will launch Google Chrome and google.com is available. After that, if user will enter 3, so this time Microsoft Edge will be launched with google.com. Let's say if user is not selecting or entering these value, instead of 1, 2, 3, if user will select 0, 4 or any other number, that time we will give the condition as else. So here we'll add else condition and we'll launch Excel. We can also launch any other things whichever we want, but as of now I am setting the condition as launch Excel. Save this path. Post saving this, whenever we'll run, we'll see exactly same output is available. So it will ask to enter the code. So let's say I'm giving 4. So this time it will launch Excel. So let me close this, run it again. Now this time if I want to launch Microsoft Edge, then I will enter 3. So it will launch Microsoft Edge with Google Docs. So this is how we can set the conditions of launching different browser set according to our requirement. So which is very much easy enough. We are not writing a single line of code. Without writing a single line of code, we can set this conditions. So that's the reason Microsoft Power Automate is called as no code RPA based automation tool. So that's all from this video. Hope you enjoyed the content. If you think so, this will be useful. Don't forget to share within your circle. Thank you for watching.